Welcome to the first session of Asian Literary Society's Parvaz Forum. And as you all know, Parvaz is a platform that is dedicated to serve humanity through its social initiative and programs. And we are glad that today we have one of the very eminent guests with us who will interact with us on the same issue of social people with special needs. And this session would be moderated by none other than our Ziba Tabassum, a moderator who is looking after our social initiatives. So I would like to quickly introduce Ziba Tabassum before she starts interaction with our eminent guest. Ziba Tabassum is a result-oriented, multifaceted social activist and dedicated special need mother with 13 years of experience supporting special need individuals, parents, and professionals. She willingly accepts extra responsibility to ensure better execution of any project. She is a fashion designer, but she chose to use her talent for a higher cause and successfully organized several exhibitions and fashion shows for differently enabled kids and adults. Volunteered for many NGOs and organizations to execute training program, research work, and fundraising events. She's having exceptional ability to understand the problem and solve it, and we all are aware about her, this talent of executing the programs and in all these activities that she has been performing on Asian Literary Society for last few months. So I would now humbly request Ziba Tabassum to kindly introduce our eminent guest. Over to you, Ziba.
Thank you so much, Mr. Manoj, for introducing me. And good evening, everyone, and hello to all our viewers. Before I start this session, first of all, I'd like to express my gratitude to Mr. Manoj Krishnan, the founder of Asian Literary Society, who has suggested this much-needed topic of discussion today. It's COVID-19, caring for children and adolescents with a special need. And I'm hopeful that the knowledge and experience shared by today's guest will surely guide all of us to survive and thrive in this pandemic. Let me introduce my guest for today's session. He's Dr. Mohammad Javed, who is based in Kolkata. He has done his MBBS from JJM Medical College, Karnataka, ALTS from King Faisal Hospital and Research Center, Riyadh. He is a gold medalist, eminent consultant physician, diabetologist with 25 years of experience. He is also an expert in geriatric care. He is attached to various hospitals of Kolkata with a special interest in long COVID patients, child care, and dialysis care. Dr. Javed conducts several free health checkup camps and medical camps at poverty-stricken region and the flood, and for the flood victims of West Bengal. He also conducts health and diabetic awareness program, stress and lifestyle management session, and pediatrics counseling. He is associated with many organizations like Swasth Mela, Kolkata Swasth Sankalp, where he is serving the less privileged section of the society. He has been honored with several awards for his contribution to the medical field and service towards humanity. Most recently, he has been awarded by NCC Bureau for his relentless participation in combating COVID-19 and caring for people affected by this pandemic. Thank you, Dr. Javed, for joining us and giving us your valuable time. And the doctors are the blessings directly sent from God for all of us. Welcome, Dr. Javed, to this session.
Thank you, Manoj. Thank you, Ziba. Now, my session will be very short and brief, and it will be very clear-cut for everybody. Now, if a child gets a sick, suppose a child is having a fever, the first and foremost thing, forget COVID. Rule out the fever first. What is the cause for the fever? 1 day fever, 2 day fever, 3 day fever, 4 day fever. The first symptom of fever is the first day. Remember one thing, first day of the symptom of the fever is the first day if the child is having a COVID. If the child is having a fever, first rule out malaria, rule out dengue, rule out typhoid, rule out urine infection, rule out any chest infection, which mimics like a COVID. If you rule out this fever, piracy of unknown origin, then COVID is treated very simply. And if the RT-PCR comes positive, so remember one thing, there is always a symptom for your COVID. Now, one thing is that COVID has been reported all over the world in the child, and it is very less seen, less effective in the child with milder illness in kids, because very rich diet and your very healthy food among the children decreases the COVID symptom. And special category child, they have got a high risk in this COVID-19. So if the child gets COVID-19 affected, the first day of the symptom, either whether the child is having a body ache, vomiting, fever, loss of appetite, breathing trouble, or running nose or sneezing, so that day is always counted at the first day. This is very important if a mother is giving a sinus symptom to the pediatrician. Now, some kids have symptoms after several weeks of COVID-19 infection. Many children have suffered from COVID, and after maybe 4 weeks or maybe after 6 weeks, they are having this COVID-19 infection, which we call as multisystem inflammatory syndrome, MIST, which is seen in Kolkata. Even I have seen my relatives, two of them have suffered. So multi-system inflammatory syndrome, which is very common nowadays after COVID. In this, a small child of maybe 5 years, 6 years will have a fever, stomach pain, cracked nipples, lips will be cracked, face will be dry, bluish distillation of the lips will be there, swelling of the hand will be there. Then one day morning, the child will say, "Mama, I'm feeling very, very weak. I can't stand now." So this is a very particular symptom, you can say. Very peculiar symptom. One morning, a child will get up and say, "Papa, Mama, I can't stand now. I can't walk now." So this we are facing now. Multi-system inflammatory syndrome, MIST, which we call. Then you can call your doctor. If the child is having a fever, give paracetamol. If the fever is not subsiding, give him cold sponging. If the child is vomiting, you can give him anti-vomiting medicine like Domstol or Ondansetron, whatever is there in the house. Then dehydration is very, very important for the children. Control of the dehydration. If the child is passing the urine, well and good. Observe the urine. Observe the temperature. For pain abdomen, you can give simple rotavirin tablet. And still, if the child is sick, not recovering, then better to consult your pediatrician, emergency doctor. And most important, at that time, when the child is having this MIST, see that one person should handle the children, father, mother, and there should be a separate bathroom, separate plate and all those things. So that time, it's very important. You consult your pediatrician as soon as possible. That is very, very important.
Right. Right. Thank you, Dr. Javed. Yes. Basically, it should be a symptom-based treatment for a child who is affected with COVID-19. Should be
Correct.
A symptom-based.
Correct.
All right. Being a parent, being a mother of a special needs child, I have lots of questions and confusions, which I would like to clear it from you.
Yes, tell me.
Do you think individuals with special needs, they are more at risk from COVID-19?
Yes, 99.9%, because special child, they have got comorbid condition. So they are always at special risk with this disease. They are always, because of the low immunity, because of the medicines, because of the autoimmune disorders, many special kids who have got cognitive disorders, who have got epilepsy, they also have got comorbid problems. They also have got a very risk factor there. So they should be handled carefully, very much carefully.
Right.
One person right. in a family should handle a child, should be isolated, family members should wear a mask, all those things which are done during the COVID crisis. Isolation and all those things.
बेसिकली इट्स अ गेम ऑफ इम्यूनिटी एंड आई नो कि हाँ स्पेशली चिल्ड्रन दे हैव ऑन गोइंग हेल्थ प्रॉब्लम ऑल्सो विच सप्रेस देयर इम्यूनिटी आई बिलीव या
इम्यूनिटी फैक्टर
एंड ओनली डॉक्टर्स कैन सी द अनसीन एंड दे कैन ट्रीट द अननोन एंड अनहर्ड डिजीज लाइक कोविड एंड सेकेंड थिंग इज कि पेरेंट्स दे यूजली गेट पैनिक्ड when their child contracts a virus.
Yes,
so
yes.
what
So
to
panic
do if a special need individual diagnosed with COVID-19?
See, the parents has to be very cool and calm, because they are the one who will handle the child properly. If a child is not in a control, you have to see the symptom of the child. You have to handle the child according to his behavior, according to his mood. If the child is very like you can say like autism child, they are very fussy, they don't sit in one place. So in that mode, you can change the children's mind, like showing the television, their proper care, getting up in the morning proper time, sleeping in the proper time, then ask the children what your next food, what food you like to have. What
okay.
during the food you can act, what next you want to do. So helping the child during the COVID is very, very important. And the mother or the father, whoever is handling the child, he should be very much cool and calm. Very much cool and calm.
Right.
And the child has to be explained, this is a germ, this is a disease, and it has to be handled. How to handle? Wearing a mask, showing the child a picture, showing him a video, showing him singing a song with him, because he's stuck in the house. He's not able to go outside. He's not going to school. He's not going to swimming pool. He's been isolated in the house. So according to his, but be sure that his meals time, his getting up time, his sleeping time is not disturbed. And you have to be cool and calm, which is very, very important. And same thing which applies wearing a mask, 6 feet distance, social distance, that has to be maintained.
And I believe ke with doctors around us who are doing a heroic job in this pandemic, we should have full trust on the doctor and his line of treatment. And we should follow what the doctors are advising us before getting panicked, right?
Yes, that is important. That is very, very important. Panicky, everybody gets panicked, but if you see, I have handled so many cases. I have never panicked. I have taken my patient party also to see the patient, which many doctors, they don't do. They don't do. Now, not allowed, this, that. But I have taken my patient party. Even I have told my patient party, wear mask, come with me, come along with me, talk to your patient. They feel very... 90% of your disease is gone with this only. Once the patient party sees the patient and the patient sees the patient party, and 90% of the disease is gone. And nutrition plays a very important role. Nutrition is a very important role.
I'll come back
People
to that
are
point.
Very... Okay.
I'll come back to this point. Like, after this pandemic has hit us, we started talking about immunity and the ways to boost the immunity system. But for a special need individual, it's a Herculean task. So what are the necessary steps should be taken to improve the immunity of a special need individual?
See, for the special child, immunity development is not right from the first day. Once the child is born, the mother milk is already a immunity factor. So if a person or child get affected with the COVID, immunity doesn't build in one day, frankly speaking. People start taking vitamin C, zinc, high protein diet, but it comes right from the first day the child is born. Mother milk was the best immunity. Still, it's the best immunity to develop. But during crisis, during the COVID-19, if the child is affected, the special child is affected, that time, see, the child is very fussy. Give him high protein diet. Stay at home. Your milk, your egg, your chicken, your bean, your soya bean, your nut, whatever the child likes, fruits, vegetables, every 2 hourly. So immunity has got a very important role, but not it will. It is not developed in a one day. Remember one thing, it comes.
Right.
What immunity you have developed. Now the people are taking vaccine. Vaccine
right.
is not a permanent solution for the COVID-19. It will protect you from the virus. How much it will protect you? It's up to you. How much immunity you have got. That will fight the
right.
virus. The people have right. started taking vitamin C, with zinc. I think best food is the best immunity. If you have healthy food, homemade food, that is the best. Jaggery.
Right.
All those things.
Even I believe that the freshly cooked home food is the best thing, and we have to avoid the junk food, lots of things, sugar.
Yes, yes.
We should avoid
yes.
those, all those packaged
yes,
food.
Yes, sugar take, junk food, all those things are very bad.
So instead of improving the immunity, it degrades the immunity system. So we should concentrate on the home cooked food.
Right. Home cooked food is very important.
Yeah.
Your cereals, your nuts, your vegetables, your eggs, dates, jaggery, homemade food, whatever homemade food is that. Whatever the child is having, just add a little bit of jaggery in date, a little bit of protein. Dal has got a very good role. I told my all my maximum of the vegetarian present to have rajma, to have dal. Soya bean has got a very good protein. Your curd.
Right.
All these things, yes.
And how important is the role of exercise since the kids are stuck at home?
Yeah, exercise for the special child plays a very important role. Since as you said that the children are stuck at home, see that the children, especially the autism children, they are very fussy, they don't want the simple sitting. See that they dance, keep dancing, singing, exercise, household work with the mother, grooming, helping the mothers in mopping the your floor, just helping hand.
Right.
Dancing is the best exercise during this COVID-19, what I feel. Dancing helps a lot for the exercise. And the yoga, which can be done at home.
Right.
If you are dancing at home, suddenly you will suddenly will see your children getting up and started singing, dancing. So keep him engaged, watching video, watching television. But be sure that your children don't see all the social media news and all. And
right.
that will create more problem. If he watches the social media news about COVID-19 and all those things related to the COVID, that will create more problem for the children. Balloon blowing.
Right.
What we did to the COVID patient, we did the spirometry. We gave the spirometry for the stress exercise. Now, at home, for a disability child, I should suggest, give your child balloon. Tell them to burst the balloon. They will enjoy bursting the balloon. It will make noise. Patak, patak, it will make noise. The child will enjoy blowing the balloon. That will help them to inhale and exhale the exercise with the chest lungs want.
And breathing exercise is quite important these days. Blowing balloons and blowing different type
yes,
of whistles. Spirometer
yes,
is also
yes.
easily available at any medical shop.
Yes, but for spirometry, Ziba, I should tell you that for a disabled child, it's very difficult to inhale and exhale. So if you tell them to blow the balloon, they will enjoy. They will buzz the balloon. All colorful balloon. Tell them to buzz. Tell them to blow. Tell them to hang in the house. That they will enjoy.
Right, right.
These are different.
Yeah, they should enjoy that.
Yes, yes. That's very important.
And for the physically challenged individuals whose therapies got stuck because of this COVID, parents are not able to manage at home. I think they should start some static cycling or treadmill. What do
yes,
you say about
very
that?
Very important. That is very important. Static cycling, treadmill in the house. Then your many things are there. Many things are there to be done.
Home-based gym equipments, right?
Yes, all yes, those. Yes. And those they can't afford, then simple walking with the support. That is also important. It's very important. And most important, those children with a special kid who are having central line, who are taking chemotherapy, who are on a cancer medicine, be sure that these children to be kept in mind, their immune system are very weak. These children's immune system are very weak. So they should be isolated properly. One person, either father or mother, should handle the case, because they have got COVID with chemotherapy. They want chemotherapy. Don't stop the regular medicine. Continue your regular medicine with the COVID medicine, because they are the more dangerous one who will be affected.
Right.
These patients should be kept in mind. Those who are on regular medicine of your immune disorders medicine, chemotherapy medicine, those who are on a central line, see that those medicines are continued. Inform your concerned doctors that my child is having COVID. Shall I continue the medicine or not? He will give you the best suggestion. And many things are there. Inform your friends, inform your neighbors. In the meantime, they will also help you. There are many things happen. Many things happen. People are ready to help. What I have seen.
Thanks. Yeah, even I have seen people are ready to help in this time of crisis.
First COVID phase, people are very afraid. But second phase, I'm very happy to see that people are ready to help. People are ready to help.
And one more thing, parents who have got their especially those who are adolescents now, they are confused about the vaccination program.
Yeah, very good question.
So do you advise them to go for the vaccination?
Yeah, the government of India and also WHO has recommended those who are above 18, they should take a vaccine. The trial among 2 to 12 years has failed in India. There was a trial conducted, but it has been failed in India. But above the 18, they can take a vaccine. It's a very good issue. It's a very good you can say, move by the government of India. They should take a vaccine. And there are few things which has to be kept in mind. Like a special child with cognitive disorders, with epilepsy disorders, with your little bit of central nervous system problem, I think better to consult your doctor. Few things has been there, which has to be like your allergic. Many people are having allergic to many diseases. Allergic to like your skin allergy. So few conditions are there in which you're not supposed to take the vaccine. So better to consult your pediatrician. Many cognitive disorders are there. Immune disorders are there. In that condition, better to consult your physician.
Respective, right.
Yes.
And now they are in the best position to advise what should be the... whether it's advisable for them to go or not. Because I know many kids, in adolescents, they have... autoimmune disorder, they have diabetes, high thyroid, epilepsy central nervous system problem, right? Lots of risk factors are there. I think doctors and the neurologists, they are the best people to advise.
Diabetes common,
and vaccination,
they can take.
I think only the vaccination drive is the biggest priority right now.
Vaccine is in the biggest priority, but how far it's going to help, it's very difficult to say, because in many countries, they have started taking the third dose.
Right.
Many countries. Like if you see USA, you see UK and many parts of the European country, 50% of the population has been vaccinated, two doses.
Right.
So now they are telling, open your mask, go to your work, open everything. Like USA, they're telling, open your mask, no need for your mask. Except same thing like our in India, 130 crore population is there. If half of the population gets vaccinated, then we also save.
Right.
We also save there. So vaccination.
We will
is
come
only,
out of this crisis. We will come out of this crisis very soon.
Sure. We have to come out.
We have to come out. And apart from the physical stress, there's lots of psychological and emotional stress for the special need parents if their child get diagnosed with COVID-19. So how can we handle this stress while caring for our child?
See, it's very difficult for a mother to handle. Same thing, child should be isolated. One person in the family should see the child so that everybody house member should not be affected. Using the toilet, cleaning the toilet is very important, because stool has got a very important, stool plays a very bad role in transmission of the COVID-19, even your urine.
Okay, right.
So if somebody is affected in the house and if he uses a common toilet, see that after every use, single use, your toilet is cleaned with a simple salt water. Flush with the salt water. Keep a bucket of salt water and see that it is flushed properly. But always use salt water. Once the affected patient has used the toilet, better to clean with the salt water. And the use of the your knobs, your switches, your remote control, that has to be taken care of. Very, very important. And child has to be told, this is a disease, this is a germ, beta, tumko ek bacteria hua hai, tumko ghar mein rehna hai. And see that he stays in one room or one big hall, watching television, his favorite channel, playing Ludo, playing Carom. So it's a matter of hardly 7 to 8 days. Blowing balloon, bursting the balloon. He won't like getting isolated in one room, but he has to be told. He should understand.
And I think if a mother and a child are staying together in the same room for the 14 days or maybe 12 to 14 days, they should enjoy that period. If it's not a critical case, they should enjoy this. Love your child, play with your child, dance, laugh, sing with your child.
Very, very important.
And those 14
play
days will go.
Dance, yes, yoga, everything. Everything they can enjoy.
Everything, do it
but
together. Just
to
leave aside all the tension of the whole house and enjoy with your child.
But mother should be very strong. That is very, very important. Yeah, mere beto ko ye ho gaya, ab kya hoga, ye hoga. That thing, it's very simple. Very simple.
That's the thing. There should not be any emotional stress or the psychological stress. Yes. We should be mentally strong. Definitely. If, God forbid, if something like this happened, just enjoy it. But take care ki kuch serious na ho bachche ke saath. Otherwise, enjoy that period.
I think, Ziba, you are the best judge.
Yeah.
You are the best judge. As you suffered, you are the best judge.
I know. Okay. So with this enriching session, I think which is beneficial to all of us, I would like to conclude the session by extending my heartfelt gratitude to all the doctors and medical fraternity for their selfless service and the sacrifice they make every day for the safety and welfare of humanity. The courage of putting themselves at high risk to keep us safe and going to the extent of even sacrificing their own lives deserves our lifelong gratitude. So on behalf of the special ed community and the Asian Literary Society, I salute your compassion and dedication towards your profession. And I would like to pay a small tribute to the true frontline warriors, the doctors, nurses, and the medical fraternity. So I request all my viewers to listen to this song written by Mr. Manoj Muntashir and sung by Mr. Pratik. For those who haven't listened it.
Nandhi si hasi bholi si khushi phoolo si wo baahein bhool gaye jab desh ne di aawaz.
Is it audible?
Hame hum ghar ki raahein bhool gaye. Hum soye nahi kai raaton se jaane matlab so jaane bujhe. नींद उसी दिन आएगी जब देखेंगे आबाद तुझे तेरी मिट्टी में मिल जावा गुल बन के मैं खिल जावा इतनी सी है दिल की आरजू तेरी नदियों में बह जावा तेरे खेतों में लहरावा इतनी सी है दिल की आरजू जब दिल की दुआ तो हमने दवा से काम लिया, वो नब्ज नहीं फिर थमने दी जिस नब्ज को हमने थाम लिया। बीमार है जो किस धर्म का है हमसे ना कभी ये भेद हुआ, सरहद पे जो वर्दी खाकी थी अब उसका रंग सफेद हुआ।
थैंक यू सो मच। दिस वर्स की सरहद पे जो वर्दी खाकी थी आज उसका रंग सफेद हुआ, दिस रियली ब्रिंग्स टीयर्स टू माई आईज। टुडे द डॉक्टर्स आर द सेवियर्स ऑफ ह्यूमैनिटी। थैंक यू सो मच। थैंक यू सो मच डॉक्टर मोहम्मद जावेद एंड थैंक यू मनोज कृष्णन फॉर दिस सेशन।
Thank you, Manoj.
First of all, okay, I would like to give the vote of thanks to you all. Deepest gratitude to our esteemed guest, Dr. Mohammed Javedji. Special thanks to Zeba for moderating today's session. And I would also like to especially thanks our audience, the members of Asian Literary Society, for their continued support. The recording of this session will be uploaded on our official YouTube channel very soon. And thank you again to all of you for your presence and participation. Thanks all.
Thank you, Manoj. Good night. Take care. Thank you, Zeba.